what's going on? You're listening to the Nighttime Show live at Hollywood Improv. Hey, this is a big deal. We are huge fans of this guy and of this band. I'm a big fan of Savage Garden, and to have Darren Hayes from Savage Garden on the show,
he's somebody I didn't know anything at all about him going in.
I know,
and then he turned out to be incredibly fascinating.
Oh my God, his story and his rise to fame is just
came out of nowhere.
It came out of nowhere, and it is absolutely fascinating. You guys are going to really, really enjoy this. And if you are a fan of music from the 90s, which I am, you should come out to the Nighttime Show April 27th. Because we have the Gin Blossoms on the show. So come out and see one of these intimate performances live. Because guess what's about to happen? You're about to listen to Darren Hayes from Savage Garden do an interview and then perform Truly, Madly, Deeply acoustically on stage while two couples slow dance next to him. That is a real thing, and it really happened on our show. So tune in and listen right now.
Our last guest for tonight sold over 30 million albums with his band Savage Garden and a solo career over the last 20 years. He's a prolific podcaster, a graduate of the Groundlings. Ladies and gentlemen, Darren Hayes!
Come on, Darren Hayes, everybody, give it
up. Hi.
Oh my God, your fans are fucking amazing.
Oh my God, I wasn't sure what you're about to say then. I was like, what is going to come next?
Oh, not crazy. They're not crazy. They're amazing.
They're crazy amazing. Yeah, I do have one crazy fan.
One?
No, I have a couple. I have a couple of restraining orders, but
do you really?
I really do.
What?
Yeah.
Tell me. It's something that happens
to really obscure people that you don't know are famous, because I'm not really famous, but it's a weird thing. If you're slightly Googleable, it's a thing. It's like, I always think I'm the sort of person to stalk where somebody thinks like, who else is taken? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And they just go, oh. And then they do those, I don't think I've been on the TMZ before. And after, have you seen that thing where they like, look what they look like now? And the thing is, for me, it's really hard because if you Googled, first of all, you'd have to know my name, and then you'd have to know like a deep cut of like, oh, that was a band. Okay. And then there were people, right? And then one of them had a name. Right. And then you see like 50,000 different haircuts, and they're all me. And then, I don't know where this story's going, but yeah, Google me.
Yeah.
It's a weird experience.
Yeah. There's a lot there too. And now because the song Truly, Madly, Deeply, this song, right? Which was a fucking massive, enormous, massive hit, right?
Yeah.
Number one, like in different parts all over the world.
It's crazy. I mean, I feel really strange talking about it because I really am, I'm 47 and I was 26, I think, when how come no one asked me about my fucking skincare regime?
Doug. Jesus Christ, Doug Jones.
I had a lot of chemicals on my face for different reasons. It's crazy because the two biggest hits that have changed my life are not really indicative of a lot of the music that I make, but you can't choose what you just
can't.
It's like your sexuality.
Yeah.
I tried to change that.
Did you try, because
of course I did. I married a woman.
You did?
Yeah.
Really? It was good.
Yeah. No, I'm here to tell you, guys who are a little bit homophobic, kind of feels the same. I mean, the other bit feels the same. You know what I'm talking about. Think about it a little bit. I'm just saying, that's the thing.
You put
a thing into a thing and then it feels good. One of them is genetically engineered to feel maybe slightly better. I don't know. Yeah. I am talking about kissing. Guys?
Right. Oh, wow. Weird. Why'd you gotta get weird, everybody?
I don't know. Yes, I did not want to be gay.
Did you want to come out when you were like?
Didn't even know I was gay. That's the strange thing. I know.
When did you find out?
I don't know. Here's a weird thing, right? So I grew up in Brisbane, Australia, which it's an amazing city, but it's a smaller town. And I was born in 72. So by the time I was even, like, thinking about even being attracted to anyone or anything, it was the 70s and the 80s, and the feedback was very much like, no.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I was like, got it, no. And that was it, you know? Yeah. I had a crush on this kid called Stephen Baker. He was gorgeous. He really was. He had braces, and even through the braces, he was so gorgeous. And I thought he was so handsome, and one other boy, his best friend, came up to me and he said, "You're in love with Stephen Baker." And I went, like, and that's how you knew I was gay, because I went like that. And of course, I said, I was like, these are imaginary pearls. Later on in the story, Darren will have a different pearls.
Yeah.
Oh, please.
Oh, please.
Oh, please.
He was lavished with expensive gifts.
Thank you.
How dare you.
And before I was talking about the butt pillow sponsor, I wasn't talking about, you know, whatever. But anyway, I just thought, how does this guy get out of my head? How does he know? But again, the message was very much, no, wrong, reject you. And then, I don't know, maybe I don't fall into that category, but for me, love really is love. And I had, you know, I had a girlfriend and I was incredibly in love with her. Looking back, I realized that maybe, you know, my hit, the line where I hit on her was about her hair color. It was aubergine. Thank you for asking. In the 90s, that was a color. But I don't know. End up marrying my best friend, and she's still one of my best friends in the world. And
did you come out while you were together, still with her? Or
yeah,
you...
I mean, I came out before I'd even kissed a boy. It was one of those things where I'm recording that first album.
Yeah.
And I go to Sydney, Australia, and I had a publicist at the time. Her name was Leonie Messer, and we were sitting opposite each other, and she said to me, "Can I ask you a really, really personal question?" I was like, "Sure." And she went, "Are you gay?" And I was like, "Oh, no, I'm married." And I had a wedding ring on, and she said, "Yeah, but every time this guy Justin from accounting," it's always someone from accounting, am I right, McDonald's?
Come on, McDonald's.
Oh, yeah. McDonald's left. They were big Doug Jones fans. She said, "Every time Justin walks in the room, you blush." And again, that was one of those moments where I was like, what? So for the longest time, everyone else kind of knew.
Yeah.
You know, and everyone was like, you're gay. I'm like, what's gay? Doing that. I was like, no, I am not. But, you know, you saw, like, and I'm so, so grateful, but the career that I had, it was just, I got to, you know, dress up and put makeup on and do strange things and really find myself through art.
Yeah.
And it was other people that sort of said, you might like penis.
Yeah. You're like,
if you like this, try cock. So she said to me, "I think you're gay." And then it was just, I'd love to make it sound all light and, but it was, for me, it was like, no, I've got my whole life planned out. I'm going to be a pop star, a very masculine one. I'm going to have kids. I literally bought a house with a white picket fence, all that stuff. But the universe just went, yeah, you have to deal with some stuff. And I'm so grateful that my family, my wife at the time, everyone was just like, okay, let's just deal with this. And after a year or so of ill-advised Christian counseling, I'm not a Christian. You know what they said? They said to me, listen, the Christian counselor said, listen, I'll give you some advice. He said, I'm attracted to Pamela Anderson. I said, thank you for telling me that. And he said, but I'm married. So when I walk down the street and I see women that look like Pamela Anderson, I want to have sex with them. But I don't because I'm married. Thank you. That'll be $100. That was our marriage counseling.
Shit.
Yeah, wow. Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
So to let me go, like to have a woman so strong in my life that would be like, you know what? I need to let you go and you need to be free.
That's amazing.
Yeah. Super, super good.
Yes.
Yeah. She's amazing. Yeah.
That's an incredible thing, man.
Yeah. Women.
That's an amazing thing.
Yeah.
Speaking of that, I rewatched the I Knew I Loved You Before. Yeah.
I did think that Kirsten Dunst was in love with me. But then it just turns out she's a really good actress. For real.
We have the video, I think, right?
She's so beautiful.
Kirsten Dunst. I know that it might sound
more than a little. This would be called harassment now.
Oh, yeah, you can't get away with this now.
I was so in love with her.
Oh my God. Come on.
Look, he hated it.
Even then. Hated it. voice is fucking amazing.
Oh, thank you.
Holy shit. I love your voice. Your voice is amazing.
I hear that you're like an amazing musician
whatever. As well. So. No, you're crazy, crazy talented, man. Like, when did you start singing? How young were you when you started?
Again, really cool. Like, I was so young that no one really said I was good at it in a great way, because I was the youngest of three kids. So I just get told to shut up. So we were very, to put it, I mean, to call us blue collar would be polite. We were really poor. Like, I think we definitely lived in a trailer park at one point. But the music that we had was all literally hand-me-down. So you had to have physical things. There were these things called, before a compact disc, there was a thing called a record. And before that, there was a cassette. Mm-hmm. And my aunts and uncles and people were into, like, Motown and stuff. So I listened to those records.
Yeah.
And that's kind of how I learned to sing. And I didn't think about key or gender or anything. I just kind of...
Lots of falsetto in those, too.
Yeah. That might
help.
Yeah.
Smokey Robinson. Yeah. That's what it was.
Now, at this time, when this came out, when these songs were hits...
Super gay.
I know. We're good. Tortured. There. What about... Who else were you opening for? Was your band opening? See what I
this
did?
This is going to sound really wild. First of all, I hope you get the idea that I don't think I'm a big deal at all. I'm really grateful for the life that I've had.
Of course.
But we didn't open for anyone. We literally went from being a band.
Nothing to being the biggest.
To doing arenas. And it was the only band that we ever opened for once, technically, was such a... incredible delight, but a tragic thing is we played before In Excess at a radio show in Pittsburgh, and it was the last show that Michael Hutchins ever performed.
Wow.
Oh my God.
I remember at the time thinking, well, it was a pretty big deal. And then, you know, because there was like 10,000 people at this thing, and we're like, we nailed it. And at the time, and this is about humility, you know, In Excess, like all careers, they were going through a period where their record at the time wasn't a huge hit. It was fucking amazing, but it wasn't a huge hit. And when they arrived, I was like, let's see what they can do. And then 10,000 more people arrived to see them. And Michael Hutchins just kind of walked through the car park. I remember looking at the dressing room and seeing this figure, and he just kind of floated on air. And I was like, that is a rock star. And incredible experience. But that was it.
Yeah. Who else was out at the same time as you?
Everyone that we got compared to, it was funny because everything.
Is it 98 Degrees? Is that around that
stuff,
time?
But what's weird is that when we, because we wrote these songs, we can't dance for shit, still can't. Well, give me a couple of cocktails and we'll see what happens.
Right.
But, you know, we were sort of like a Hall & Oates or a, I don't know if there's an example of that today, really, because we were just songwriters. I sang and then... This pop music was a filthy word. Everything was grunge or there was Alanis, right? Mm-hmm. Or there was Pearl Jam or the Seattle scene, and hip hop was huge. Listen to that. Where's that come from?
Yeah.
And it was considered so unsignable, so uncool. And then one day the zeitgeist changed and it was like, we need to sign you. And then we came up with things like Backstreet Boys and Britney and everything.
Right. Yeah.
So we were sort of in that wave going,
but you were writing your own music, and a lot of those were sort of manufactured artists in a way where they've got like huge teams behind them assembling the music they were doing.
We were so lucky, and I've been like that. Like, I think the way I feel about my career is that I know that the bits that you might be aware of are incredibly... it's crazy that those opportunities were given to me, but I would still be making music if that hadn't happened. And because of the songwriting... And the singing and things like that.
And you've had a big solo career as well.
I've had a long solo career, You know, and it's funny, like in the UK I'll play like the Royal Albert Hall, or in Australia I'll play the Sydney Opera House, and here I'll play like, don't you know who I am? Like, no one knows who I am. But it's a beautiful thing. It's an amazing, crazy thing.
That's actually the best way, because you can go there and have the famous person life come back here and then just a normal person.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. It's weird. I was listening to Ashley. First of all, Doug Jones.
Oh, my God. Yeah, I know.
What an incredible career and amazing man. But listening to Ashley Green talk about even the paparazzi thing, I never had that. Even in the height of the band success. Because I think on some level I didn't want it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think I was very, very aware that that wasn't what I was into. My artists that I loved were people like Peter Gabriel or Kate Bush, just long-term artists who might one day be on the super nighttime show with Sexy Men show podcast.
I got to do a quick shout out for Ashley Green on this real quick. A couple of years ago, I wanted to have a charity event for Children's Hospital for on my birthday. About
Steven, I think she made it pretty clear she was not interested.
I know. Damn it all to hell. But we were trying to, I was trying to put this event together with Chris Daughtry. He was a part of it.
Oh,
and
wow.
A bunch of other like wonderful people. And like I was like, oh man, it would be so great if Ashley Green could like, because we had met and I was like, it'd be cool if she could like come to this my birthday party. You know, it's just a nerdy thing to ask. But I was like,
at a cake shop.
At a cake shop. It was at a make your own cake shop. Nice. Such a weird thing to try to do. And she fucking rolled in, and the amount of people that followed her to the front, it was the building was vibrating from the amount of people that were coming after her. And she came inside, she made a cake, she ate cake, she hung out, she was so fucking nice. And then when it came time for her to leave, I was like, I'll walk you out. And people were like shoving me and pushing me around. And it's
like,
crazy,
it's my birthday.
It's my birthday. Don't shove me, you son of a bitch. But I felt like I can imagine like you going back to Australia, you going, you know, like
no, doesn't happen.
Yeah.
No, it really doesn't. It's very sweet. Like when I get recognized, it's funny. It's that disappointment thing. I mean that no,
what?
Listen, I know I'm a big fucking deal. I'm just saying. There's fame, and then there's sort of, what is it, infamy or something? I joke about it, but it's like, yeah, I've been lucky enough to do some things that if you take the time, like most great actors and people that we know in comedy have done stuff. But, you know, it will be this one person who's amazing. I'll be at a coffee shop in Australia, and I'm going to speak Australian dialect now, so tell me if you can understand it. And I'll be, hasn't started yet. And I'll be there, and someone will go, oh my God, is that Darren Hayes from Savage Garden? And I'll go, and my version of Ashley Green's like, click, 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 here's the paparazzi. My thing is like, if I hear this very subtle thing, oh my God, is that Darren Hayes from Savage Garden? I'm so attuned to that very subtle noise. And I'll go, oh, hey. So, and then I'm like, yeah. And I'm like down for a hug and a picture and whatever. But then people gather and they go, who is it? What is it? Who is he? Who is it? And then I have to watch their disappointment. They go, nah, never heard of him. Nah. What do you sing? And then they'll come up to me and say, what do you sing? I'm like, I'm not going to sing it for you. Not because I'm an asshole, because I've done that before. And they still go, nah, don't know it. And then they'll say, can I get a picture anyway? Like, what? Sure. Okay. Then you can explain who I am to people.
Sing a Britney Spears song, exactly. Would ya?
No, baby. Yeah. But it's lovely. And you know the story. I mean, look, I'm a fan. Man, I'm a fan. I waited outside of... Oh, this doesn't sound good now. Let's just say I've been a fan, okay? I've stalked people. No, I haven't stalked people. No. But I get it. I totally get the, like, I still get nervous when I meet anyone that I think is famous. I dismissed myself from Doug Smith before. I averted all eye contact. I was like this. No, but I get it.
Matt, you and me are both stand-up comedians, and I know we both say a lot of things that are very offensive on a regular basis. Do you ever have trouble sleeping at night?
Yeah, not because of things I say, though. It's just because I have lousy pillows.
Oh, okay. So you don't have like a horrible feeling of guilt sometimes for the awful things. Oh, that's nice.
Never. I'm proud of the horrible things that I say to people.
That's good. That's a good way to be. Sometimes I do have trouble sleeping, or I did have trouble sleeping until I got this brand new pillow.
What kind of pillow?
I mean, this is next level stuff, Matt. This is a pillow. You've never seen a pillow like this because until recently it did not exist. It's called the buttress pillow. Mm-hmm. And it is shaped like a butt, and it has little legs, and you're not going to believe this. You got to go check it out. TheButtressPillow.com.
So it's like your face rests on a butt.
Your face is pressed into a butt crack while the legs support your neck and shoulders, basically. It
sounds comfortable.
It is very comfortable. It's ergonomic. Am I saying that right?
Yes.
Ergonomic, functional, all natural, and it's absolutely beautiful. Check this out. This is from their website. Soft but supportive, with the feeling of a butt. All right, and the sweet spot is between the thighs and the cheeks, which will gently cradle your head and support your neck. Great for side sleepers, back sleepers, and stomach sleepers. It's squeezable, slappable, face variable, relieves stress, you know, from having a long, horrible day. What do you want to do at the end of a long day?
Put your head in a butt.
That is 100% right. Well, you can dress it up. You can dress it down. You want to throw some PJs on it?
You convinced me, so where do I go get one of these?
You go to thebuttresspillow.com. Thebuttresspillow.com. That's T-H-E-B-U-T-T-R-E-S-S pillow.com. Go to thebuttresspillow.com, Matt, and get your sleep on. You'll have much better dreams. All right, let's get back to the show.
Well, we need your help because we have a beautiful audience out here, and we have a $150 gift certificate to Katsuya to give out to this audience.
Thank you so much. Babe, we're going to Katsuya, finally. We can't afford it.
We also got this here. This is the second runner-up prize. The second runner-up prize is, here we go.
Cash.
It is 2 VIP pizza passes to Shakey's Pizza. Be our guest at Shakey's Pizza. One medium, one topping pizza with 4-piece chicken and mojo potatoes. Yep, and then you get, this is a free Mojo's. There's a free Mojo's in
PCM,
here.
PCM, I'm telling you, Shakey's Pizza, by the way, I would much rather go to Shakey's Pizza than Katsuya.
How dare you? Katsuya is a beautiful, beautiful restaurant. $150 can buy you at least 3 pieces of sushi.
I love Shakey's Pizza.
But do they have Mojo potatoes?
They do not have Mojo potatoes.
Do they have fried chicken?
Those are worth...
So here's what we got to do.
Okay.
Mike Glazer, you're going to run around in the audience, and we're going to find couples, and we're looking for the best couples, okay? So raise your hand if you are a couple. You have to have your significant other here with you. If they're not here, go fuck yourself.
I mean, those two people should reproduce immediately.
Yeah, they're
immediately
beautiful, right? Let's go over there.
Just make babies, sell them. I'll buy one.
Okay, hold on one second. Get your arms back in the air, please. Who are you? Who are you pointing at? Who do you want to start with?
Oh, this couple here.
Right here.
Yeah. Oh, do you know what? I'm just going to go with this. I thought that your son, is that your son?
No.
Okay. Let me try to give you an adjacent compliment. Okay. Are you single?
Yes.
I'm married. How dare you, sir? How dare you?
How dare you be single and so attractive?
No, these people are someone love.
Those two right there. Hey, by the way, where's our KLOS listeners? Where's our 95.5 listeners? Frosty and Freddy,
which, speaking of,
right there. Yeah,
so,
baby.
So if we want to start with them, hold on. What were you just saying?
We've been married 38 years next month.
Oh, I like that.
Got married.
That is a good point for them. All right. Okay, here we go. First question. How did you meet? Keep it fun, keep it short and sweet. How'd you meet?
High school party.
Oh.
We've been together since I was 13 and he was 14.
Wow.
Holy shit. That's pretty good. All right, second question. Most romantic date?
Halloween.
We went and saw Halloween,
the movie, when it first came out in a drive-in.
The original Halloween.
The original Halloween.
That's a great answer.
That's great. Awesome. Okay, you guys are in the running. Yeah, all right. Okay. Who else have we got?
How many total? I want to go. Okay, right here, and then I'll keep working around.
We got a couple over here too.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm waiting for the question.
Okay. Over here.
Here's a couple.
Right here. I like how bold you're being. This is great. Engaged. You're engaged.
Engaged.
What are your names?
I'm VJ.
And I'm AJ.
VJ and AJ.
Oh, I like them.
Engaged.
I like them. Okay, they are engaged.
I like that their initials sound like Vajayjay. There should be extra points for that.
Vajayjay. Big question. What is a weird sex thing that your partner is into? Weird sex thing.
I'm going to plead the fifth on that one.
All right, ask her. Ask the lady. You got to give an answer.
That's why I'm marrying him. So I plead the fifth.
Two fifths.
Okay, 2/5 make a foot fetish, I believe. In the back, in the back.
How are you?
Good, thank you.
What are your names?
Thomas and Teresa.
Thomas and Teresa.
Okay, Thomas and Teresa. How did you meet? Make it fun. How did you meet?
Well, she was my next door neighbor when we were 14 and 15.
Oh, that's so cute.
Neighbors.
All right. What's the sexiest thing that's happened recently between the two of you?
Lord have mercy.
Tell me a sexy thing. I want to hear
his
a sexy
answer was
thing
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy. I fucked my neighbor.
I don't know. Sexiest thing. Well, it's her birthday and we're staying down at the JW, so that might happen tonight.
Oh. I shut. Like them. They're in the good running also. Yeah. Keep in right mind, here? Those guys are in the running. Yeah.
All right. Hey, Glickman, you cut me off. I'm going to work over here,
work
go over
the
there,
room,
and then come
the
back
room,
to the middle.
Bitch.
All right.
Hey,
how are
wait,
you?
Wait, Glazer.
Yep.
You got to take Spider-Man over here. We got a guy in a fucking Spider-Man costume.
Okay,
go to
hold
Spider-Man.
On one second.
Go to Spider-Man.
Yeah. Wait, what do you mean Spider? Oh, Spider-Man. You really are.
I assume Mary Jane over
is this
here.
A motherfucker?
Would you like to stand up for this?
This is real.
Spider-Man costume. What's your name?
Alex.
Hey, Alex. What's your name?
Alex.
Double Alex.
What's going on? Okay, what's the? I'm afraid to ask. What's the weirdest sex thing? He's spinning some webs. Y'all know what I'm talking about. All right, tell me. I want to hear weirdest sex thing. Throw it out.
Do you want to take this one?
No, I think you got it.
Okay. You know from the movie Spider-Man where he's like hanging upside down? Uh-huh. We do that.
Great answer.
Okay. Great all right. Answer. I can yeah get into that.
Okay. Right. I left these people hanging and I had to come back. Okay. What is your name?
I'm Sam. She's Alyssa.
Sam and Alyssa.
Oh, I like Sam and Alyssa. All right, Sam, go for it.
Okay, well, what's
Sam,
the question?
Here's the question. What'd you do on Valentine's Day?
All right, so...
edibles. The answer is edibles.
he took edibles and he's still on it.
So I'm 6'9" and she's 4'11". So shit kind of got interesting.
Good answer.
Oh, I like that.
Okay.
I like them a lot.
Yeah.
Wait. Go
real
back
fun
to them. Go back to them. One more question for them.
Oh, sure.
Weirdest. What's it?
I mean, he can dunk her.
Have
like,
you? How long have you guys been together?
How long have you been together?
3.5-4 years.
Have you met each other's parents?
Yeah, I'm taller than all of them.
When you met the parents, did you go visit them in wherever they live or they come here?
So I'm born and raised in Minnesota and we were there. And they
he lied to them about my height. He said I was 5'3" because he was embarrassed that I was 4'11".
All right, here's what I'm thinking. And get I pick those two back there.
Okay.
They're my couple.
Okay.
Darren, you got to pick your couple. Which one do you like the most, Darren?
I mean, come on, Mr. Hat in the back.
Yeah, the guy
next
in the back
neighbors
there. All right, so
tonight's potty night.
Those two couples, let's bring the two of them up here. Come up towards the stage. Those
right this way. I'll show you how to get up there.
Follow Mike Glazer.
Yeah, give him a hand, everybody.
Yeah. And sir, if your girlfriend could stand up, sir, if she needs to stand up.
Here's how I feel about this, and we've discussed this. And Darren, if you're okay with it, I'd like to move forward with this.
Yep.
Only way to tell which couple is better is for them to slow dance while you sing a song.
They need some encouragement.
Are you down to do that, Darren?
I mean, yeah, I'm down to sing.
Let's get your guitarist up on stage.
Okay, get
up here. Come on, buddy.
I want to invite my buddy Joe Cessari, who's an incredible musician in his own right. This is Joseph Cessari.
Don't walk away. Come up.
Joe, come on up.
Come on.
So,
come on.
Hey, Steven, They said no, so we have an opening because they decided no. Would you like these two right over here? What about these two up front?
How about the two who've been together
38 years?
All right, together 38 years.
Yeah.
Holly Frosty
you
and Frank
guys are
Fierce.
Awesome. And you know what? You can
right, come on up.
Yeah.
Come on up.
Come on up on stage.
Yeah, come on up there. Yeah.
Sure, come stand next to me.
All right, so here's I'm going to place you guys. All right, so you two go stand over this way. Go keep going. All right.
There's not much room there. But.
Okay. All right. So there, you're gonna just slow dance, and then these two guys are gonna slow dance over in this corner. And I want you guys just witness them, and then I'm gonna hold my hand over their head, and you guys can decide which one is the better slow dancer.
All right, but also because the thing is, like, I was once on Google. And if I'm going to sing this fucking song, like, don't be fucking laughing at every single thing. Because even though they're gorgeous and stuff, I'm like, you know, it just occasionally, if you feel like making Joe feel really talented, you can all be like, oh, that's really good. I'm going to listen. But that's cool as well. But
let's give Darren Hayes some real love, everybody. All right. Take it, baby. Let's dim the lights.
I'll be a dream, I'll be your wish, I'll be your fantasy. I'll be your hope, I'll be your love, be everything that you need. I love you more with every breath, truly, madly, deeply do. I'll be strong and I'll be faithful, 'cause I'm counting on a new beginning and a reason for living and a deeper meaning. Yeah, I wanna stand with you on a mountain. Of the highest powers in lonely hours, the tears devour you. Well, I want to stand with you on a mountain. I want to bathe with you in the sea. Here in my head. Feels like the sun is coming out. I just know that something good is gonna happen.
I think every woman in the room just got pregnant.
Okay, let's go. Hang on, don't leave.
Okay, Steven's gonna go up. We're gonna judge who is the best couple. All right.
Okay, here we go. I need you to applaud to vote. Here we go. We're gonna try it. I'm gonna do here. I'm gonna do there. I'm gonna go here. I'm gonna go there. Are you ready? We got this thing. Here we go. You're taking the $150 gift card to Katsuya, and you guys get all the motherfucking shakies you can handle. Guys, I just want to wrap out this show by saying a couple quick things. We love doing the nighttime show. It is a thing that we adore. It is like a thing that we work our asses off to put this thing together. Sometimes we don't make no damn money doing it, but we fucking have a really good time. We have a very fucking good time. And it was a big month for us, getting people with tattoos, getting to have Darren Hayes, getting Doug Jones. After years of trying to get him, and Ashley, after years of trying to get her, this is a big deal. So we appreciate you guys being here. And Bill Duke, yeah, for years we've been trying to get Bill, and we finally got him. And so I'm going to end by saying this. We'll be back in March. Take a look on the Improv website. Most likely we'll be back for my 40th birthday. Unless I'm dead by then. But I shouldn't be. I should be fine. Birthday. I should be fine.
Your 40th and final birthday.
you son of a bitch. You rat bastard. So we're going to leave you with this. Darren Hayes, where can people find you in the world? Where can people find you?
I'm not stealing merch. I'm Darren Hayes, 2 R's, E-N. Darren Hayes, Twitter, Instagram, all that stuff.
What about your friend? Where can we find you, my dear friend? Joe Cessery, Instagram,
Twitter. C-E-C-E-R-E. It's very Italian, I'm sorry. He's amazing.
Mike Glazer, where can people find you in the world if they want to hunt you down, you Emmy-nominated son of a bitch? Where can people find you?
Sure, it's at Glazer Boo Hoo Hoo.
That's the best. What about Sarah Salthouse? Give her a giant round of applause for working on the show tonight and her comedy sketch. Loved that.
Killed it.
our whole team that fucking helped us put this thing together. You guys, we couldn't do it without you. And we have glow-in-the-dark nighttime show pins. They're $5. If you got cash, throw it in there. We'll give you some cool... It's cool stuff. It's very cool stuff. And we want to end with this. Mike Black, where can people find you on the social media?
At Mike Black Attack on all social media.
And Matt, where can people find you, buddy?
Links to everything at funnymatt.com, or if you're annoyed by me, let me know at mattwalkersucks.com.
Which he does. People do hate him.
I spend a lot of time on Matt Walker.
People love that website. You can always get me at Stephen Glickman, S-T-E-P-H-E-N, Glickman on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube. Check out the Nighttime Show website, www.thenighttimeshow.com. Subscribe to the podcast on wherever you like to listen to it, because you'll get to listen to this show and past shows, and it's such a fun thing to come out to every month. Big thanks to Krispy Kreme Donut, The Buttress Pillow, Big Mouth Inc., Katsuya, and Shakey's Pizza, and we're gonna end with this, guys. I recently had an incident happen. If you listened to me on the Heidi Frosty and Frank show, I did injure myself and possibly some other people, as well as damage some public property. And I would like to take this time to apologize to the Irvine Spectrum, and we're gonna show that clip as we gather our things and leave. Thank you so much. I did break a carousel. Thank you so much, and good night.
I just had an incident. I really should issue an apology, if that's okay. Can I make a serious thing? I should issue an apology to the Irvine Spectrum Mall. If you follow me on Twitter or Instagram at Stephen Glickman, S-T-P-H-E-N Glickman, I know you guys do. Then you guys may have seen it already happen. I was down there this past weekend with my family. My mom decided to buy our entire family tickets to go on the carousel together as a family. And so I did. I got onto one of the horses. I straddled the horse, got up on it, and I started making a video on my phone because I just thought it'd be a funny video to make. And I said in the video, hey folks, when people tell you not to do something and you want to do it, well, you gotta stand by your decisions always and believe in yourself. And then I was gonna go, I'm on a carousel, like that was my plan, is to then go, I'm on a carousel, and that is not what happened. What happened was, I said, you gotta stand by your decisions and believe, and as I said believe in yourself, the carousel started and the horse collapsed. The pole went straight to the ground and started dragging and sparking on the ground and rattling against the ground while I wrote it, and my whole family was laughing all together, and I was like, oh my god, I'm breaking the carousel.
Guys, when the haters say you can't do the things you want to do, you gotta do it anyway. And they said, oh yeah! Oh my god, I'm gonna break you. I'm breaking the carousel. Oh my god. Weight Watchers, help me! I'm breaking. Someone call Jenny Craig! I am breaking. I made a terrible life choice.
Thanks for coming out to the Nighttime Show. Good night, everybody.
Wow, what amazing, incredible.
Great performance.
Oh, my God. People were in tears in the audience.
I saw somebody crying.
Yeah, I know. It was amazing.
You were crying.
I was crying.
It's because you were out of donuts. But
I was hurtful, so hurtful. he really did an absolutely amazing and incredible job. And we owe you so much, Darren. Thank you so much for doing the show. We really hope that you come back and we get to bring you back and do something maybe for Comic-Con or
it'd be awesome.
Oh, my God. People would go crazy.
There were people
I mean, there were people that drove tremendous distances just to go see Darren Hayes, like, because he doesn't perform that much anymore, I don't think.
Yeah, I mean, he does solo stuff now and then, but this, I mean, this was really...
In an intimate setting like this is rare.
It's, that's really the key, is the intimate setting of...
And that version of that song is something that you haven't heard before.
No.
Which is cool.
Yeah. I'm happy that it happened on our show, for sure.
Yep.
Thanks for listening to the show. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share the Nighttime
Show.
And
if you like 90s music, come out to our next live show, April 27th at the Hollywood Improv, where we have the Gin Blossoms.
Yes, that is a fact. So come check that out, Jack.
or if your name is not Jack, you should also come check it out.
Please. Go to www.thenighttimeshow.com to get tickets and to subscribe and enjoy. And thank you so much for listening. And tell your friends. You guys are the best. We love you. Oh.